down with the Premier today, and Philippe Couillard gave me some insight into the negotiating process, as well as his commitment to public education.
It's what always happens in negotiations like this. We're dealing with close to 500,000 employees. It's not a simple organization first, but also the dynamics of a negotiation itself is always the same. Each party starts by staking their ground and saying, well, this is what I can start with, and then you start negotiating. There's always a tense period where people try to build what they call a rapport de force, or strength relationship between the two parties, and one day it happens where people say, okay, let's stop this macho game, who's going to win, who's going to be better than the other. Let's try to understand where the other side is coming from, what is good in what they're telling me, and vice versa. And when this happens, then you set the stage for a win-win agreement, which happened. Win-win for everyone, public sector employees, patients in hospitals, children in schools, and the taxpayer. What I hope is that now we'll have a very peaceful moment, for more than a moment, 5 years, because it's a five-year deal. And then we can all concentrate on improving our public services, both in healthcare and significantly in education.
All right, significantly in education. And that's something that I've been hearing from parents and teachers. They want a real signal from the government that you want to invest in public education. Give me that signal. What is that signal?
It was given. You know, the moment I knew for sure that we had balanced the budget and it was solid, we immediately put money on the education system, not because of pressure tactics, not because of demonstrations, because this is why we wanted to achieve fiscal balance, to find again the means to invest in areas where we like and we love to invest, which is again education first and above everything. Even healthcare is below education in my scale of values, although it's an important mission too. So the moment we knew it was there, it was not.
For days, the Premier has been saying that he's no fan of exploring for oil and natural gas on Anticosti Island. Well, now he says he's ready to pull the plug on the project started by the former PQ government. I sat down with Philippe Couillard this afternoon, and he tells me he's willing to face the financial consequences of pulling out.
I said I don't want to have oil and gas exploitation on Anticosti. Why? Because I want my children, our children, grandchildren, their children, to have access to protected natural environments in Quebec. And there will not be that many of those 50 years from now. So that's one we must protect. I've said it very, very strongly. I think it has been heard loud and clear. You know, Anticosti for me is a special case, and not only for me, but for our society and the future of what kind of Quebec we want. And frankly, I don't think it was a good idea.
So are you going to tell companies like Petrolia that those contracts are canceled?
Well, we'll have to have a conversation with them. Obviously, they've now heard what I've been saying today again and in the recent days and in Paris, and before Paris, by the way, as well. I think they know the writing is on the wall. We still want to work with them in the project that they have elsewhere, in the Gaspé Peninsula, for example. Hopefully, they will see it as good news, and so they will work with us. But I'm not going to be, as I said in French, the destruction of a natural environment like Anticosti will not bear my signature. I've said this very, very strongly, and I believe it. It's a personal conviction that is very, very deep in me.
I just want to clarify, though, because it will cost you money if you cancel those contracts.
Maybe.
Are you saying you're willing to do that?
Yeah. You know, when we say we must have a balanced approach with economy and environment, everybody says that. It's easy to say. If you look at it globally, this is what we're doing. But each project is a different world in itself. In some projects, the environment will prevail on the economy. Anticosti is one of example. And some other projects, economy will prevail on the environment in the balance of things. For example, the cement factory in Gaspé, which again, we're going to use as an opportunity to develop our carbon capture technology and help our green tech companies to develop and test that technology in projects like Port Daniel, the cement factory, and eventually and hopefully we can export that know-how and that technology elsewhere.
The emissions are massive. Talk about massive.
After fossil fuels, cement factories factories are a source of significant emissions. But was I to go to people in Gaspé who have reached unemployment levels of 20% and tell them that because we fight climate change, you will not have access to industrial jobs in Gaspé? No way, I cannot do this. But I'll say to them, okay, we'll do that project. And we're very cognizant on the impact of our emissions. Therefore, we'll ask our companies and other partners to come to the plant and see how we can capture the emissions, use biomass instead of fossil fuels to supply the energy for the plant. All this is being worked on as we speak. So again, let's try to transform problems into opportunities. That's a good example.